what you did. Yeah, I know, and I wanna talk about it, and I know you don't. I've been holding guard for so long, so long, and I don't know where to start, I don't know where to start now. Tell me where you hide, where do you go? Tell me is she nice, she knows, I know.
So guys, today your girl is back with another video. First of all, I haven't uploaded a video in like 2 months, like legit like 2 months. But today, back with a story time. So today's story time is gonna be about how I found out I was pregnant. I'm 27 weeks, your girl is due in September. Okay, so boom. Let's get into the story, alright? So, let me see. So like, alright, so boom. So like 2 weeks into January, right? I was like feeling so sick, y'all. Like, I was feeling so sick. Like, I would just wake up and just throw up. I couldn't eat nothing. Like, I didn't have an appetite for anything. And then if I did eat something, I just literally threw it up, right? So that was going on for 2 weeks. Like, literally 2 weeks. It didn't matter what I ate, I threw it up. The only thing that I could keep down was smoothies. So I would drink smoothies because it's like a smoothie place down the block from my house. So I would drink smoothies because that's the only thing that I could keep down. And Pedialyte. So I would drink smoothies and Pedialyte because that was the only two things that I could keep down. Then Pedialyte's supposed to help you gain back the hydration and stuff like that. And your electrolytes that you use from throwing up. And I was throwing up like, I'm talking about y'all, I was throwing up like 10 times a day. When I say legit 10 times a day, I mean I was throwing up 10 times a day. I drink water, I threw up the water. Anything. Like I said, the only thing that I could keep down was smoothies. And all I was doing was sleeping, just throwing up and sleeping. Like, it was crazy. Like, it was really, really crazy, right? So then one day, I went to go see somebody. And then when I had came back from where I came from, boom. So I came back and my mother, because I live with my mom. So my mom, me and her usually like get our cycles around the same time and stuff like that. So she was like, you didn't get your period and stuff like that? She was like, you sure you're not pregnant? So I'm like, I am not pregnant. Like, I'm thinking like, why would she even, you understand what I'm saying?
Why?
So one day, we woke up or whatever, and I think it was like the end of the month. I went to the hospital and everything. Okay, so boom. I was throwing up so much that I went to the hospital. Cause I thought something was wrong. Like, I thought I had a stomach flu or something like this. And this is like before the coronavirus thing.
Coronavirus! I'm telling you, shit is real!
Became like really, really huge before we even went on quarantine, before any of those things. So I had went to the hospital, right? Because I'm like, damn, I keep throwing up. I've been throwing up every single day for 2 weeks. Then on top of that, I'm throwing up like 10 times a day. Not just one time throwing up. I'm talking about just blah, blah, all day, to the point where I feel like, you know what I'm saying? So I was just sleeping and throwing up. So I went to the doctor, sat in there. I was sitting in there for mad long to the point where I left. So I didn't even go and see if I was pregnant then. So I think I didn't find out until like 2 weeks later, like legit 2 weeks later. Me and my mom was in the house, and then we had, she was like, you need to take a pregnancy test, right? So I'm like, all right. So she like, I'm about to go get it right now. So I was in my room. So then she was like, let me feel your stomach. So she was trying to see if like down here was like hard and stuff like that. So then she was like, it's hard. She was like, it's hard. And I was looking at her like, and then I started crying because I'm like, oh my God, like, So he went to the store, he came in, he got the pregnancy test. You know, you pee on the stick over. I even still got the pregnancy test. Got the stick, pee on it. And then we had left it sitting like on the counter in the bathroom. And then I went in her room and we was just sitting there waiting. I didn't even go look at the pregnancy test. He got up like 5 minutes later. He went in the bathroom, looked at the pregnancy test, and it said I was pregnant, right? So then we was like, oh man. So he was like, he wasn't really upset. He was just like, whatever you want to do, it's up to you. He was like, but I don't feel like I can get an abortion. Whatever. At this time, I was 20. My birthday just passed. I just turned 21. So I'm like, oh my God. Like, I'm really pregnant. Like, I'm really, like, legit pregnant. I wonder why I was throwing up and feeling sick like this, right? So now, I gotta schedule me a doctor's appointment. So I went on the ZocDoc app. It's this app called ZocDoc. And I went on there to schedule me an appointment because the hospital by my house, it's like, I don't have the patience to be sitting in there for 2 hours, 3 hours to go and wait to see a doctor. So I just went on ZocDoc and set me up an appointment to go see the doctor. And I think when I went to the doctor, I was 9 weeks. When I went to the doctor, I'm 95% sure that I was 9 weeks pregnant. And the baby wasn't nothing like, but like, he was like this big. I'm gonna show y'all the picture if I can find it. If I can find a picture, I'm gonna show y'all. But he was like this big, or I'll put it somewhere so y'all can see it. But he was like legit this big. And that time, of course, I didn't know the gender or nothing like that. And then, so yeah, I had scheduled that doctor's appointment. And then that's when the whole, like, everything started to get, like, super duper serious with the coronavirus. So now I'm like, bro, like, I'm pregnant in the middle of a pandemic. So now I can't go to the doctor the way that I want to go to the doctor. And so now everything was just really, really crazy. Like, everything was crazy. We had to do, like, we had to wait and see when the next time we were going to see the doctor. Then when you go see the doctor, only one person could be in the room or nobody could come in the room with you and stuff like that. It was crazy. And then, like, right now, I just started my third trimester, like, maybe 2 days ago. My first trimester was the worst. I couldn't eat nothing. Like, I was just throwing up everything. You know, like, people be talking about, oh, they get pregnant, they get cravings, they want to eat this, they want to eat that, this, that, and third. No, I didn't get none of that. Even now, I still don't have none of that. Even now, I still don't really have, like, a huge, huge appetite to eat. Like, I don't have no huge appetite. I don't have no huge cravings. The only thing that's good about now is that the throwing up is not, like, as crazy. I threw up yesterday. I ate some oatmeal and then, like, as soon as I finished eating, it's just bleh. But, like I said, the throwing up is not as excessive as it was in the beginning, because I was legit throwing up like 10 times a day. I'm like, what is going on? Like, what is going on? For 2 weeks, every single day, just throwing up. Like, it was crazy. But that's how I found that I was pregnant. And so today, I'm 27 weeks and 3 days. I think I'm 27 weeks and 3 days today. And I'm due in September, so I got 12 more weeks until my son gets here. And so I'm going to be a mom. And it's hot. So y'all, I'm gonna be a mom, but I'm happy about it. At first I was nervous because anybody would be nervous, right? But at first I was like, oh my God, like, what am I gonna do? Because, like, I'm gonna get pregnant right now. But everybody around me was really, like, supportive and stuff like that, and everybody's really excited. Like, they're really just waiting for the baby to get here. especially my mother, she's so happy to be like a grandmother and everything like that. So that was a good part. It wasn't like really like no like, but I didn't really tell nobody like until up until recently, like maybe literally like 2 weeks ago. Like that's how recently. Otherwise than that, nobody really knew I was pregnant. And my stomach is not huge. Matter of fact, I gotta show y'all pictures too, because my stomach is so small, like it's not huge, so you couldn't really tell I was pregnant. You can't really tell I'm pregnant now. Like if I wear certain things, you wouldn't even be able to notice or be able to tell. I found that I was pregnant, so that's the story time. What I'm gonna do is at the end of this video, I'm gonna try to answer some pictures showing y'all like my stomach progressions and ultrasound pictures. Ultrasound pictures. Right in this video, let me show y'all these lashes. Actually, that I'm currently wearing are from my lash company, Zan Lash Bar, on Instagram at Zan Lash Bar. These are the lash casing, guys. They are so cute. And here's a pair of one of these lashes. This style is called Attitude. And then the style that I have on now is called Princess. I have 5 different styles. I have cutie, babish, princess, attitude. I can't even remember what the other style is, but I do have five different styles. But go on Instagram and follow my lash page at Zan Lash Bar. See it right there. I'm gonna put everything in the link in the description below. And they're 100% human hair, 25mm mink lashes. So yeah, go get that. So this is the end of this video. I just wanted to do a story time telling you guys how I found out I was pregnant. And I think that I want to take you guys on like the whole journey. I'm going to try to do a labor and delivery video. But I don't know, because we still are kind of like in this pandemic thing. So I don't know.
Coronavirus!
Who's like, I got to figure out. I got a doctor's appointment in a couple of days. So I could figure out who I could bring in the hospital with me, who could come, how many people could be in the room, if I can record and stuff like that. But if I can't, we're just gonna try to finesse it. So you know what I'm saying? So yeah, but more uploads coming soon. And thank you for watching this video. And subscribe, like, comment, share. And if you haven't seen my last video, go watch my last video, how to start your own business. Okay? How to start your own business. And I'm also will be doing a vendor list. I need to start selling vendor lists so that you guys can get your own vendor list so that y'all can find out where to get your custom cases from. So you guys can start your own businesses. But yeah, so subscribe, like, comment, go watch my last video on how to start your own business. I have more videos on my page. You guys can go watch those videos too. I will link all of that down in the description below. And thank you for watching. Stay tuned at the end of the video if you want to see my stomach progressions and ultrasound pictures, because it's coming. But yep, thank you. Sleeping past daylight, I'm waking up, you're not by my side. Baby, that ain't right, I wanna be there with you. I really do be missing you. Everything I do is for you, and I really do adore you. You're getting so big now, and you're making me so proud. Cause you are such a star, and you know that you are. So every single little moment, I can't be there to hold your hand. I need for you to know that, need for you to know that. Anything should happen, anything should happen. Should be alright, know that you'll be